Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Matt Meyer Road to the Show series here in MLB 14 The Show on the PS4. We are trying to fly through June and into July here in the 2016 season with Matt Meyer. They are hoping to keep pace in the AL West, but those pesky Seattle Mariners are so good in video game baseball. I don't know how they do it, but they are almost unbeatable in MLB 14 The Show for some reason. They're already out to a 10-game lead, 10-11 game lead in the division, at least over us anyway. Meyer's going to hit this ball pretty deep to right field, but it's going to be caught at the warning track. Just misses a Meyer moonshot by a few feet. Well, you know, that and the warning track, maybe 10 feet. I don't know how much he missed it by. But it was out there. He gave it a ride. He gives this one a ride as well. And this one's to right center. And it's off the top of the wall. Talk about just missing a Meyer moonshot. There it was. It couldn't get much closer than that. He'll settle for a double that goes off the fence. We're going to see a replay and see just how close he was to going yard here. Hits it out to the gap. And this will come down. Let's watch this. A little hard to tell from that angle. I don't know if that was the top of the wall, the base of the wall. One way or another, he hit the wall and did not get it out. So we are 5-5 in the 11th, and is that a base hit? No, I think they're going to make the play on him there. And he is put down in extra innings. Let's see how this game ends up. Well, this is kind of how the Rangers play ball here. They lose this one in extra innings. Just can't quite get it going to the point we had it last year. We're closer and closer to the 500 mark. Well, we're two over. But we're definitely not playing at the clip that we were last season. We have to kind of find that success once again. Meyer hits this ball pretty well to the gap. That is going to roll to the fence on two hops. He has himself another extra base hit as he settles into second with a double, taking on tough pitching here against the Tigers. But he goes ahead and gets that extra base hit on Max Scherzer. First it was Verlander, now Scherzer. That's a tough duo to take back-to-back in games here if you're a hitter. But he does quite well against Scherzer on this pitch and gets an extra base hit. So Detroit up 3-0, however. Scherzer doing a nice job, but that's another base hit. Meyer's got two hits against Max. How is the rest of the team doing? Obviously not so great if we're getting shut out. So that is a good at bat, 15 points, solid contact and a base hit. What can they do? Can they rattle Max Scherzer now and get a rally going? We will have to see right here. Meyer on first. This ball's a little flare, and Scherzer fields that himself. He's out of the inning. Seems to keep escaping danger. So Meyer's two hits. That's five total for the team. You do the math, there's only three other hits through seven innings. That's not good. And they get shut out. Scherzer gets the win, 9-3. Did he go the entire way? I'm not exactly sure. One way or another, though, he gets a shutout victory. So we move on to the last game in the series. And Meyer's on the bench, but he's going to be called upon to pinch hit in this game. So no more rest for you, Matt Meyer. Get up there, grab a bat, and see what you can do in delivering some damage to the Tigers off the bench. It's 8-6 in the eighth. That is nailed down the right field line and fair. It's going to roll to the fence. Runner coming around third. Will he try to score? Here he goes. Relay. Nope, they're going to hold on to it. They score the run. And Meyer has come through big time with two RBI to tie the ball game on this double. How about that for clutch off the bench? Look at this. Tailing towards the right field line, but it stays fair and gets down in that corner. Causes big time trouble for the Tigers as it scores two. It's 8-8 now. This ball is going to be a sac fly. No! It's off his glove. It drops. He's going to score the go-ahead run, and it's 9-8. What a crazy, wacky ball game. We almost got hit in the face by the on-deck batter there. That wouldn't be the first time that happened in Major League Baseball this season. I'm talking to you, Milwaukee Brewers and Ryan Braun. But what happened on this play? Ah, that's an entrant into the Sports Center, not top 10 right there. As it goes off the heel of his glove, maybe? The outside of his glove? I don't know. Was the sun a factor? Not sure. But he doesn't make the play. I don't know. That was a fairly shallow ball. I don't know if Meyer gets to tag up on that one or not and score if it's not dropped. But look at the Rangers. They bat around. This is the same inning, folks. They really opened up the floodgates. It's 14-8, and this is not a replay. It's another lash down the right field line. Another runner coming around third and will score. Meyer gets two hits and three RBI in the same inning. Wow, how's that for off the bench? You get in there and get two at-bats in the same inning? That's unheard of. The Rangers win the game 15-8, and that's cause for fireworks in the dugout. Yay, fireworks in the dugout. We gotta love that. Just as long as no one catches on fire, it is all good. So it's a 15-8 victory. 11 spot in the eighth. Wow. Okay, we'll take that more often. That would be awesome. Looking back at the calendar and when the next game action will be for Meyer, will it be this Cleveland series leading it off? Yeah, it looks like that's the case. Let's get started and let's jump into this game at Progressive Field. Oh, it's looking beautiful, as all the parks do in this ballgame. Cleveland Indians not doing so well, 33-46. Let's see if we can take advantage of that and jumpstart our own season. Meyer guns him down at second. There you go. Don't go stealing on him there. He's actually had some pretty bad luck throwing runners out lately. Whether it's the pitchers not getting the ball to the plate in enough time for Meyer to throw him out, or whether it's been throws just a little bit offline, whatever the case, but he guns one down right here, and so we had to include that. It's a 2-2 game in the fourth. 1-0 count to Meyer. He finds a pitch he likes. He pulls it down the left field line. It's going to be fair and off the wall, and a quick carom right back to the left fielder. He's got a chance to throw Meyer out at second. Nice play right there. The run does score, so it's an RBI single, and he is thrown out at second. This is hit hard, but right at the right fielder. Nothing doing right there. Runners will have to stay where they are. So for this game, Meyer gets just the one hit, and it's an RBI, but they fall short 4-3. Ah, tough one right there. Thought we could maybe take advantage of the Indians while they're down. It doesn't happen in the first ball game of the series. Let's move on to the second. See if we can have better luck today. Just one game above 500 at 40-39. Second inning, no score. Runner at first. Meyer is going to take this down the right field line. It's going to stay fair and... oh my goodness, that got over the fence. The leap could not bring it back. It goes into the bullpen. It's, well, it's sort of a Meyer moonshot. It was more of like a Meyer just over the fence shot. But either way, he admires it as it flies out. Thanks, guys, for that. In the comment section last time, I kind of liked that. So Meyer hits it out, and let's watch it again. Masterson is victimized by this high fly ball that carries, and just over the fence and over the glove and into the Rangers bullpen. He'll take it, his fifth of the year. And it is a 7-2 ball game, however, for Cleveland in the ninth. Meyer's not giving up. Hell no. He hits this out to right field and has a base hit. He wants to start this rally. Down five runs, no problem. Let's get it going. Got to start somewhere. You saw us put up an 11 spot in a game, in a comeback. But it's not going to happen here. The Indians close it out. And this is another loss for the Rangers. We're now sitting at 40-40. A 500 ball club, underachieving if you ask me, looking at where we came from last season. It's definitely a notch down. But Meyer had two hits, including that home run, and two RBI in the game. His team's only two RBI of the game. So he's got a five-game hitting streak going. He's just over 300 with his average. Things looking pretty good for the catcher right now. And we are looking to finish up June with a victory, maybe. Let's see. The last game of June will be in Kansas City. Looks like we won the last game of that Indian series as we're now 41-40. Meyer hitting 500 over the last four games, and he does have that hitting streak going of five games, I believe. Should we make it six? This one's hit to the gap and right center, and oh, he just misses the Meyer moonshot. Are you kidding me? That's the second wall ball in the series. That one definitely hit high off the top of the wall, just missing a home run. It was a line drive shot, too, had it gotten out, but it doesn't. Texas will take it, though, because they are leading 4-0, and he gets another good at-bat here with a single to center. So a multiple-hit game for Meyer, and things are playing out well for him and the team today. You see 17 points for a good at-bat, four-pitch at-bat. all that good stuff. Taking off on the 3-2 pitch with two outs, and this is going to allow him to run for a while because it's fair down the line. Right fielder misses it, and he is going to score easily all the way from first base. They tack on another run on a triple. I think they'll call that a triple, even though he had a little bit of trouble out in right field with it. So it's 5-4. Kansas City comes right back, though. Meyer's going to hit this one to center, and it looks like a routine out. But no, he drops it. He drops it. Get to second base there, buddy. We don't want to force out. Oh, wow. That's a crazy play and definitely worth another look. Lorenzo Cain drops this ball. What happens here? Let's see. Ball hit okay, but not terribly hard. He just didn't look that one into the glove, I guess. But the Royals have a huge inning of their own. They score, wow, how many did they score in one inning there? Something like a 10-11 spot like we had that other game. And they win 15-6. That one hurts. And we're going to have to end this episode on that game. There we are. Just a 500 team, 41-41. But Meyer is heating up, 3-11, 5 homers. Come on back and see where he can take this into the month of July. We'll see you then. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.